time, in the happy days of long ago, when every child had a fairy godmother, there lived a little girl named Ella. Her own mother was dead, and she lived with her stepmother, who had two daughters, and they were both so lazy and selfish that they made their little stepsister do all the work. At night, she would be so tired that she could only creep near the kitchen fire and rest among the cinders. And that is why everybody soon gave her the name of Cinderella. Now it happened about this time that the king's son gave a splendid ball. And among the happy ones to be invited, the happiest were Cinderella's proud sisters. Poor Cinderella was not invited, and she went back to her work sadly, for naturally she too wished to go to the ball. When the great day came, Cinderella was busy helping her sisters prepare for the great event. After they had gone, and Cinderella was all alone, she sat down by the fire and began to cry. Oh, I wish, she cried. Then she heard a kindly voice say, "What do you wish?" "Oh, I wish to go to the ball," said Cinderella through her tears. And as she looked up, she saw a strange lady with a magic wand in her hand. "I am your fairy godmother," she said, "and you shall have your wish this very night if you will obey me. First, you must go into the garden and bring me the largest pumpkin you can find. Then bring me the mouse trap, the rat trap, and two green lizards which you will find." Cinderella brought them all. Then the fairy godmother waved her wand, and the pumpkin became a golden coach, and the six mice were changed into white horses, and the rat into a nice fat coachman, and the lizard into two footmen. And with another wave of her wand, Cinderella was clothed in a beautiful white robe, and on her feet were the most exquisite little glass slippers ever seen. "Now, remember to leave the ball before 12 o'clock," said her fairy godmother. "Otherwise, the magic spell will lose its power." Cinderella promised, and away she went. When Cinderella entered the ballroom, the prince was charmed with her beauty, and he would dance with no one else. Cinderella was so happy that she forgot all about the time. Just as the clock began to strike 12, she remembered and ran away as fast as she could, and one of her glass slippers came off. The prince ran after her, but the only trace he could find was the one little glass slipper, and Cinderella reached home with none of her finery left. Next day, the prince issued a royal proclamation to marry the lady that the slipper would exactly fit. And the slipper was carried about from house to house. When they got to Cinderella's house, the proud sisters were in great haste to try the slipper on. But alas, their feet were too large, and they tried slipperily. Cinderella was then allowed to try the slipper on, and behold, it fitted her perfectly. Just then, her fairy godmother appeared, and with a wave of her wand, Cinderella was again changed into the beautiful lady of the ball. Now the prince begged her hand in marriage, and Cinderella forgave her proud sisters, and the prince married her, and together they lived happily ever after.